5, 4, 3, 2, I let one go. Pow, get the f*** though. I don't bluff, bro. Aiming at your head like a buffalo. You a roughneck, I'm a cutthroat. You a tough guy.
Man, busy. And today we are talking about The Walking Dead. I did not do this too much, but I thought, why not? Because I watched the episode last night, and it was, I want to say, by far one of the greatest episodes I've ever seen. I loved it, everything, almost like everything about it, the flashbacks, and then we got another time jump, and this is insane. Like, I'm loving it. Like, everyone was saying that, oh yeah, if they get Rick Grimes, this is it on the show, right? Yeah, but they're not gonna kill him off, but I mean, like, I didn't know anything about movies, I didn't know anything about any of that other stuff that could have happened, so my thought is, oh, if he's not gonna be on the show anymore, then they're gonna kill him off. But truth is, they didn't kill him off. They are sending him off, and the Rick Grimes story is not close to done, as far as I know. There's been reports, and if you watch The Talking Dead, they expanded on it. They were talking on how Rick Grimes is going to be having, like, his own movie. I'm pretty sure Andrew Lincoln is going to be the star of it, but he is going to be in movies for AMC. And it's gonna expand the universe, and yeah, it was crazy. Like, the whole entire episode is him, like it had like a hundredth episode vibe. You know what I mean? Like, it had callbacks to the earlier seasons. We got to see Herschel, and when I saw Herschel, I honestly kind of like I can't say cringe. What's the word? I'm not saying teared up, because I don't really cry during things like that, but I kind of got tense, like super tense, because apparently, shortly after he filmed this scene, like, maybe a couple weeks or something, he ended up passing away, as you guys know. He passed away a couple weeks ago, and that's apparently a couple weeks after they filmed, or maybe a month after they filmed that scene with Herschel in it. Herschel is talking to Rick, and you can see it was kind of like a father-son relationship. All the info that, Herschel is giving to Rick, saying that, and talking about how Maggie is strong, and I don't know, just giving him a lot of information, just letting him know it's okay, you know what I mean? But this is just amazing. We got to see more of Shane, kind of like Shane and Rick kind of talking it out, and what happened, Rick saying that he didn't want to do it, and it was funny how, like Rick is saying, oh yeah, I gotta go find my family, and then Shane says, oh, well, one could argue that it's my family. And immediately I thought of everyone, like, on the internet, like talking about this. I don't know. Just like he's like, oh, anyway, speaking of my family, how is my daughter? Saying, I forgot what Rick said. Rick said something like, oh, yeah, she has your nose. I forget what it was, but they had a good laugh on it. And then they were talking about the first episode and how, like, one person can change it all, because the dispatch said that there was two people in the first episode, and then there was apparently three, and that third person is the one that shot Andrew Lincoln, in the first episode, which caused him to go into, like, a coma, or whatever you call it. So, that was a kind of a good thing. We got to see Shane, we got to see Herschel, and we got to see Sasha. Sasha, her speech was, I don't even know how to explain her speech, but she was standing over tons of dead bodies. And as you guys know, Sasha, the actor that plays her, is, doing her own. I'm pretty sure she's part of, like, a Star Trek TV show now. I'm almost 100% positive. I'm not sure, though. I'm pretty sure that's what she's doing right now. But, yeah, we got to see good cameos, and got to see Herschel. That's my favorite one. And, but it was just cool, because every time we get Rick about to wake up, it was like Shane or something, like, kind of like saying, oh, wake up. And it reminded me of, I think it's called After Earth, the movie with Will Smith and Jaden Smith, when he's like, I think, sleeping, and then he sees his sister or whatever, and then she yells, like, does that little jump scare saying wake up, and he wakes up and he's about to, like, I forget what the case was, but I mean, it kind of reminded me of that. But right now, the show's reminding me of a bunch of different things. Like, it's reminding me of The 100, for an example. Because, as if you guys watch The 100, you will know that they went through a 5-year time jump between the 4th and the 5th season. And it was like a 5-year time jump. And it was amazing. I loved how they did it and everything. And then at the end of the fifth season, sorry for spoilers, if you watch the 100, you don't want to get spoilers, like, fast forward 20 seconds. But at the end of the 100, the fifth season, they go into another time jump. And I think it was, like 100 years or 50 years or something. I don't even know. I haven't watched it in a while, but I think it was, like, 100 years. They forced it, and, I don't know how they're doing that. I think that show's going downhill, but I'm still watching it. But right when I saw how The Walking Dead did that another time jump, I was like, oh my god, the 100. It was like the first thing I thought of. And I went crazy. When you see those new people, some of the actors look kind of familiar, but you see them running, right? And then all of a sudden you hear, and you look and you see a friggin' little girl. Like, when she should know, she shouldn't be like, she needs to be aware of strangers. But right when I saw her, I was like, no way. Like, I had a little hint. Then it started zooming in on her, and then I saw the sword in the back, on her back. And I was like, oh my god, no way. Then all of a sudden, she picks up the friggin' sheriff hat. And oh my god, I cried, bro. That shit was crazy. I got so excited. Judith is gonna be kicking ass, and it was insane. So I don't know if you guys are excited as I am about the whole Judith thing, but like I've heard, she's like the same age as Carl was when he first started wielding a weapon. So this is insane. I'm loving it all. The whole episode had so much meaning to it. Like, this whole season we've heard things on how Maggie wants to kill Negan, and we've heard that left and right, and the truth is, like, I mean, like, we know Negan is well deserved. He deserves it. He did some crazy stuff. And then honestly, when Maggie went to go talk to him, he was saying a bunch of stupid stuff, like, oh, I said I didn't enjoy it. But honestly, at first I thought he meant that he actually enjoyed it, like, but he was just saying that stuff to really piss her off, because what he wanted obviously was to die, because one, he doesn't know where Lucille is, and that's like his what's carrying his wife's soul, I guess, in his eyes. And he was really showing it. And then one of my favorite lines of the episode is when Maggie was talking to him, and he was like, oh, kill me, oh, please kill me. And she says to him, oh no, you're worse than dead. I thought she was gonna say, oh no, Negan's already dead, but she was like, nah, Negan, you're worse than dead. And I was like, oh my god, he's dead. But like, I don't know, I'm loving all of this, like I said, and I'm really hoping you guys are too. We got to see so much. We got to see, especially the end. I thought when Rick first, like, was running away from the walkers, and you see everyone running towards him to help him out, I thought that was real. And then he's like, oh, you're not real, and then, truth behold, that was not real. You got to see the horse, and if I remember straight, more correctly, I don't know, the horse had like a zombie bite, so you get to see the horse walking sideways and all that. And Rick is just trying to stick with the flow and try to get out of there, because I mean, Rick is like, he had like a big ass wound in his stomach, so I mean, he's trying to get out of that. But yeah, we got a lot of different hints. Of we got a trailer for the next three episodes. I didn't put that in the clip. I'm surprised. I showed you guys a clip right now. It may be there, it may not be there. I've been getting hit with copyright left and right. So if I get hit with copyright once, I'm gonna have to take off those clips and just leave this part. But like I said, I'm loving this. You got to see some different things. Like, apparently in the comics, the Whisperers are big. Like, they're no good. So you get to see the trailer, and you see walkers going about, and if you listen, you can hear them whisper, oh, where are they, or something like that. It's because I'm pretty sure that's what the Whisperers do. I don't read much of the comics, but like, apparently the Whisperers are, they mask themselves up as walkers. I don't know, this is just what I've heard. Like I said, I'm not too great. I have trouble with the comics and stuff. I don't really look into it and stuff. I need to, because I'm interested, you know what I mean? But yeah, we get to see a lot, and this is it. Like I said, this is crazy. I'm loving all of this. We get to see what they look like in like 6 years from now, whatever. I'm pretty sure it's a 6-year time jump. We get to see, what's her name, Carol, with long hair. Look, She looks like, what's her name? From Once Upon a Time, the girl that played Snow White, or whatever. That's who she reminds me of. And we got to see Michonne with long, even though she already had long hair, but it's like thicker. I don't even know. We get to see a lot. I don't know if it showed, what's his name, the Glenn and Maggie's kid. I didn't really pay attention to that part. But now we're getting like 6 new characters, I believe it is. I can't remember. We get to see them running in the field, and right before Judith saves their butts. And yeah, Rick Grimes is alive. I didn't think that was going to be the case, but yes, he's alive. And apparently, yeah, he's getting his own movie trilogy, apparently. I don't know if it's a trilogy. I don't know. All I know is getting some... The Rick Grimes story is not dead. That's all we can say. That's all I can say at this point. But I'm very excited to see what else is to come. I hope you guys are too. I have 15 minutes before my bus comes, so I gotta go. I have school right now. But yeah, this is crazy. We get to see so much, and I'm loving every single thing about it. Like I said, we Maggie kind of took pity on Negan, or she's just grateful that he's in a much darker place. So I mean, she bounced. I really not much I could say. What's her name? The trash lady, kind of. She saw Rick, and right when she saw Rick, she was like, "Oh please, help me out. No tricks. I want to help out a friend." That made me gain so much respect for her. Like, you have no idea. Like, oh, he saved me. I need to save him. Like, honestly, I can't wait for the next freaking episode. You have no idea. But yeah, like, I don't do many videos like this. Like I said, I want to do this as a job. So if I keep getting more stuff, I'm going to keep doing Walking Dead videos. I'm going to do as much as I freaking can, guys. I'm doing this. I want to say for you, but I'm doing it for me too, obviously. I'm not going to front. Like, I love this. But yeah, we get to see so much. We get the line right before he blows up the bridge kind of pays off everything in the show. He was like, "Oh, I found them," and then poof, he blows up the bridge, and you just see bodies drop, and then he's the only body that ends up washing up, and it's insane. I love this so much. So as far as everyone knows, they're gonna think he's dead, except for Jadis, I think that's her name. Everyone's gonna think he's dead, except for Jadis, obviously. I don't think we're going to see much of Jadis. And Rick Grimes, I don't know if he'll ever make a cameo again. They said he's done with the show. But, I mean, I'm not going to confirm that at all. Because, for all we know, if we do get another, like, 2 or 3 seasons, I want to hope he comes back, you know what I mean? But, yeah, so everything's going on is just crazy. We got to see Judith and Negan talking in the future. Maybe they have a relationship. Like you saw in the flash forward from last season or 2 seasons ago, you got to see Carl's imagination of everything. And Negan was there. You remember that? So, I mean, I don't know if that's like something that's they're trying to point out. But like I said, yeah, this is your man busy. I need to make sure I get ready right now. It's 10:03. The bus comes at 10:15, so I better hurry up. So yeah, this is your man busy. I tried to cover as much as I can. If you guys just want to talk about it, I'm down. Like, just help me. Just subscribe, like, comment. I'm down to listen, guys. Like I said, this is your man busy. Peace. So I just made another video, right? So, I made this video, obviously. I posted it. I got hit with copyright. It took the video off of YouTube for a couple countries, including the United States. If you are able to watch this and you're from the United States, then that's cool. But this is my second posting. I got rid of the first scene, so just hoping you guys enjoy this. You're man busy, and yeah. Sorry for the, yeah.